Friends, I've got another way to do knurling in Tinkercad, so let's get cracking. You can find Tinkercad at tinkercad.com. I always choose sign in with Google. This is the homepage. I'm going to bounce to designs. If we look down through my projects, we've got a few knurling projects. I'm going to click on this one and I'm going to choose Tinker This. This is, of course, a template. It uses the sweet SVG Helix and it makes a sweet knurled part. Of course, you can follow the tutorial. The trick was slick, but this part is a little bit resource heavy. I've got a second way to do this. This is the template for version 1. Let me show you how to get to the template for version 2. We're going to get there with a bit.ly, friends. Simply type bit.ly KNURLM10 and press enter. This takes you to the Tinkercad template. Of course, it is set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy and tinker. You will immediately have an exact copy of my project. This includes ZDP's awesome thread. And then also we've got a part right here that is simply a cylinder, 15 by 15 on every side with a bevel of 2 and segments of 10. We're going to turn this into the cutting tool. It is so simple, friends. All we do is pick measurements that fit. Remember how this design was size 15, so we're just going to cut in a little further. We simply need to change the radius. I'm going to take this down to 7.2. That is less than 15. I want the outer radius to be 8.5 so it sticks out a little bit past. And press enter. And then we want the inner thread height to be super thin. I'm going to type 0.1. That way it is ready to cut. I'm going to keep the outer thread height set at 2. I want a single turn, so that way it goes one wrap all the way around. I'm going to stay with 60, but I want the height to be just a little larger than my shape. Remember, this was size 15, so we're simply going to type 16. And we're going to keep the counterclockwise. That way that thread is cutting in. Now, if it doesn't snap immediately, just click on any one of your numbers and retype it. There I press 2, and it snaps in. And if we make it a hole, you can see how that is going to trim our shape. Select them both, do L for align, and choose center, center, and also center vertically. Double check to make sure it's cutting the way you want. If you want it to cut in a little more, you can adjust any of the numbers. You can change your radius. Let's say I make this 7.1 or 7.15. That cuts in more. If I take the inner thread height and I make it 0.2, it also cuts a wider swath. So you can instantly adjust this to make the pattern you want. When you're happy, simply do Control D. Flip it with the mirror tool, just like that. Grab those two and do Control D. And then I like to rotate 22.5 or 45 degrees. You can take your pick. I'm going to do Control D to wrap it all the way around. And you want to make sure it covers the entire shape. Once it does, grab everything. Choose Control G and take a look at the knurling you just created. How cool is that? And of course, to make it into a 3D printed thread, I'm going to click on this one, choose C to cruise, and I'm going to drop the M10 on top of here. I do want to sink it in just a little ways. And then of course, I'm going to grab them both, choose L for align, and center and center. Now friends, you can make any threads you want. I've got a tutorial that shows those as well. I've also got a template that you can check out where I actually use this technique to make a sweet quick release for my microphone. As I wrap up, I want to say thanks again to AZ3Dp for getting me started down this thread path. Do check out their channel. They've got a lot of fantastic projects. I also want to send a huge shout out to ZDP189 for all the work he did with the Tinkercad threads. A quick thank you, too, to everybody supporting me via YouTube memberships. There are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. One of my favorite benefits of it is you get early access to videos. And, of course, thanks to everybody supporting me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. There is a fantastic messaging area. And, of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, thanks to you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep Tinker.